there's a little app on the called E3 time travel, in which we can travel to 3 years of E3 and compare. This is comparative 360 video. Okay, so back in the day, this is what last for 360 video. It's hemispherical. It's on an SP360, which I got for $100 from Radio Shack, which was closing down that year in downtown LA. I actually got two of them, which you can put back to back and do full 360, but I didn't try that until Gamescom that year. So let's jump forward a year. Here we are in E3 2016. These guys here. Some guy wearing glass. As we go inside. I haven't set the sound up yet. Okay, he's checking us in. Now this was filmed with Gear 360 and also with Kodak SP360 4K cameras. So we can interact with this video, gamify it later, which I'm going to do.
Hello?
Yeah?
Adios?
Out of the detail. So this is what you should be doing when you're in this video, looking up. I know to do this because I've done it so many times in VR and non-VR. So actually it was big best that year, so let's carry on. Into the scrum. And again look up. And the really cool thing about Gear 360, it has no idea thing, it's anything issue. Although this is 2D, figured out how to do 3D later on that year with two Gear 360s. The reason why 360 video is augmented memory. All these guys you never noticed walking forward. So this is a scrum. This is just the first intro. Let's leave it. Leave it. Shall we check it out? What I'm going to do is add more interactive layers to this. And this is just one way to control it. We can do it with gaze. And I'm just using the Windows Mixed Reality HMD to make this video. But we can do it with Oculus. It is supposed to be Oculus, but HTC Vive, Meta. So all these guys don't really realize you don't need to queue up. You've been there a few times, you know that. He's happy. He's noticed enough. Gear 360. So this was my dash in with an SP360. But the event I filmed with for two pairs of it's SP360 4Ks. So let's go to forward another year. Now we've time travelled. I'm a year older. And check out the palm trees. This is what you should be doing. So I'm going to get you score points for looking at stuff I think you should be looking at. Maybe you have stuff, monkeys crawling up these things. Make it even more interactive. So here we are. E3 2017, which was much sunny, apparently. There were police sirens going off around there, but the sound's turned off for this, so I can make this video for you, which you can view in VR, of course. And if you noticed, we're now in 3D. So we jumped from hemispherical in 2015, 2D 360 4K to 3D 360 4K. Like that person there is in 3D. And we're just beginning to mess with what this means. So you can understand that I've filmed the entire 3-day shows for 3 years. More than that, but these are the VR. Now we can start messing with that. I've never noticed that person before. And if I let this play on, we will go inside and it will be the first day. E3 2017, but if you get bored, you can just click, go back to a year or go back another year. This is what I mean by VR video, it's time travel. I've actually figured out after about 4 years I don't need to carry that around. So, this is just a quick intro to flowers. I can have these score points, picking these things, collecting coins, and I can then stuff away now. Giving away for free. Probably see some dude on Reddit do this now. You wouldn't have to listen to me here going on. We could have you just walk into anything you want to see, which I've captured in VR over 3 years, which I'm now going to get on to doing. Let's just walk you in and show you the difference in 3D. So if you're messing with VR, the fun is 99% is making stuff like this. Now, in 3D, the cursed thing is that. I'm going to show you the flaw in the camera that I'm using. A second. This is a Booz 3D camera, and it has one flaw. Which is that. Otherwise, stunning. Because now we can see the same atrium. 3D, the signs in 3D. So we can pause the video here, click on one of these, and I'll get to actually take you there. Which is what I'm going to do. So here we are. This is the point where I noticed Facebook at E3. That's a very quick look. I'm bored. I'm going to go back to 2016. I'm getting younger. My clicker is not working. I'll get that done. Sorted, I see. So, that's a quick look at E3 time travel. Which will be available on Windows Mixed Reality, Oculus Rift, HTC Vive, HoloLens and Meta 2, and even maybe Magic Loop by the time I finish it. Will they finish it? Thanks for watching. Hopefully you've watched it in VR.